It's my pleasure to introduce to you the man that God has anointed with a miracle ministry, with a message designed to bring help and blessing for your mind, soul, and body, God's man of faith and power, Reverend A.A. Allen.
Glory to God. Amen. God bless you, friend.
You happy tonight? How many feel the presence of the Lord under this canvas? Raise your hand up. If you feel God's power, will you say amen?
Amen.
Now, here is a short inspirational message from the book of 1 John. I'm reading the third chapter, the 21st verse. Here it is. Beloved, if our heart condemn us not, then, and I say then only, then have we confidence, that means faith. John here has condensed the word faith down to confidence. Then have we confidence or faith toward God. And whatsoever we ask of him, we receive of him because, or for this reason, we keep his commandments and we do those things that are pleasing in his sight. So I've said to you last week, it was God's will that none should be sick and suffer. God entered into a covenant with his people. He said, I am the Lord, thy God that healeth thee. He said, I will take sickness away from thee. He simplified the covenant further and declared, I will take all sickness away from thee. And I showed you as he led his people out of bondage, out of captivity, out of 3 million, there wasn't one sick, disease, or affliction, because all the children of God believed what the Lord said. I said, they believed their pastor. Their pastor's name was Moses. And he said, the Lord will take all sickness away from thee. And you know, friend, they didn't know a bit more than to believe what he said. Wouldn't it be wonderful if everybody today had pastors who preached to them that God would take all sickness away, and all the members of the congregation would believe it?
Yes.
Why, if God healed his people in the time of Moses, he heals his people in the time of Alan. Our God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. But listen, the same thing that made people whole in days gone by will make you whole today. What was it that brought healing and deliverance to them? It was their faith. Christ himself declared in the 5th chapter of Mark, the 34th verse, there's the lady. And if thy faith have made you whole, then, hear me, it was this woman's faith that brought into to operation a mighty supernatural gift which struck at her sickness, disease, and infirmity. That was the gift of eating. And that woman recovered. But listen, it was her faith that brought that gift into operation. And if you look further in the 9th chapter of Matthew, about the 28th verse, here are two blind men. Here's what Jesus said to them. He said, according to your faith, it shall be done unto you. Then the woman was healed because she had faith. The two blind men were healed according to their faith. In the 14th chapter of Acts, the 8th verse, a man at Lystra who had been born impotent in his feet, he had never been able to walk. He heard Paul preaching, and here is what the scripture declares. The scripture says that Paul discerned or perceived he had faith to be healed. Hear me. You either have faith or you don't have faith. You can either be healed or you will not be healed. But you will be healed according to your proportion of faith. But your proportion of faith is given to you by God. He is the author and he is the finisher of our faith. But our proportion of faith is given to us from heaven by God according to the amount of holiness in our own heart. Faith comes from God, but God doesn't give everyone faith. If that's true, devils would all have faith. The ungodly and the sinful would have faith. But God has reserved all his promises for his children who have faith. This is why he said in 1 John 3:21, if our heart condemn us not, that if you've gotten out of your heart and have rid your heart and cleansed your heart of all sin, rebellion, self-will, that which brings condemnation, then in your heart you have faith instead of conviction. Then if our heart no longer condemns us, then we have confidence or faith in God. And the very next verse says, and whatsoever you ask, we are going to receive from heaven, receive of God, because of this reason. Because we walk in his statutes, we keep his commandments, and we do them, and we do the things that are pleasing in his sight. There is only one thing that's powerful enough to cleanse you from sin. That's the blood of Jesus. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And we have been cleansed by the blood of Jesus as we repent of our sins and turn our back upon our sin because we're sorry enough to quit. We are cleansed from every stain and from the guilt and the condemnation leaves. And from that very moment, we have faith. So bow your head now. I'm going to pray. I'm going to ask God to speak to you, to loose your liberation and set you free and make you a child of God. So bow your head and say, God, be merciful to me, a sinner, and he'll do it. Father, I pray for everyone who watched this telecast who heard me preach. Let the Spirit of God go out into the homes of the people. Let it bring condemnation and conviction. But let the blood of Jesus Christ cleanse from all stain, all guilt, and all sin, and set them free, I pray, everyone that have watched this telecast today, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
God bless you all. In the name of God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Be still and know that I am God. Faith comes from hearing and hearing through the word of Christ. Overhearing what they said, Jesus told them, "Don't be afraid, just believe."